It has been a while since we've done another Derby Shop update. Just wanted to give you guys an update on all the changes and everything I've been working on here during the fall and winter off season of Demolition Derby here. This is what I've been busy doing, and you can see the difference, hopefully, since last time. We now have all of the walls finished, sealed off, painted wood all the way around through here, and we now have insulation across the entire ceiling. All through there, that took a lot to do for ourselves to get up in there. We actually drove my van in here with all the cars out, sat on top of the roof of my van, and managed to get the insulation up there, clear plastic, stapled it all off, airtight seal, worked out really well. And then last but not least, we finally have actual lights here in the shop. As you can see, we have those four fixtures, and that's not all of them. I will be getting more, but that's as much as I have for now. We will be coming in where you can see some of these outlets up through here. We're going to get more of them on the front half of the shop, which we have wired into light switches over here. So as you can see, all off, and then I will have a total of four switches. So we have every bay of the garage set up with its only set of lights for that. So I can kind of control where we're working at. We don't have to have all of the shop lights on at one time. A little bit easier on the electric bill. So it has been a long time coming, guys. 4 years we've been working on this shop, this Demolition Derby shop here. And most of it has been done by myself with my family helping. Only things we had done professionally was the things you gotta hire out to do, like this professionally done concrete floor and the metal roofing for the building. Also, if you have not noticed, we now have a gas furnace hooked up in here. Overhead heater works, runs great. We got our own shutoff valve ran in here. We ran this trench, this underground, all the way over to my house, tied it in with the house gas line. So I don't have a separate utility bill, and I can run natural gas on my house and natural gas here in the shop. Works out fantastic. Actually, over this way, I have a thermostat set up on the wall. Right there, thermostat tied in so we can set our own temperatures, keep it relatively cool when I'm not out here, just enough to keep things above freezing. And then we're gonna be out here for a whole week and we can crank this thing up, have it nice and toasty. Things will work out just great. So now that this has finally come along, oh my goodness, I can get cars back in here. We pulled all the vehicles that were sitting in here out just so we could get into the ceiling, finish the insulation, finish the electrical wiring, get these ceiling fixtures in place. Now that that is done, I'm gonna rearrange all the vehicles, get them put in here. And when I do that, I need to think ahead of which cars are gonna run next year, which ones are gonna be beginning of the year, which ones are in the fall, and get them in order so I don't have to bury all the way to the back and dig one out for later on. Obviously this thing's not running yet. We have some other priorities before it. We're gonna get some other vehicles in here, park them along the back row, and definitely not going to fill this thing as full as it was before. I wanna have some space to actually walk around the cars and work on them, so that'll be better off. We're only gonna put two of them up here side by side next to the Lumina. We're gonna keep that corner bay completely open. That's gonna be the workbench, tool area, stuff like that. As you can see, I'm in the middle of sorting all the tools, everything. I've thrown stuff in boxes, brought it all over from the other cinder block garage. We're not gonna be building cars in that garage anymore. That is storage only, or for my daily drivers, hopefully in the future, to park them there out of the winter. But we're going to bring some other cars up here in these front bays, and this is where we're actually going to be working on cars, where the floor anchors are, and up in this open space here will come along a long ways. So things are turning around, guys. This just goes to show you, if anybody out there, if you guys have this dream of having your own man cave, your own Demolition Derby shop, whatever, start small. I started working on cars outside in the backyard, did that for a couple years. Finally, we got relatives to give us just a little garage bay to put vehicles in. Then we moved here to this location on our property, and we still had a couple cars sitting outside. We were working in that cinder block garage, and in the time being, we were building this shop for the last 4 years. You can't always have everything you want instantly, just like this shows you right here. I could not afford it all at once, so I have been building this whole building, you know, a year at a time with what I could afford and what I could do on my own to keep costs down, little bits at a time. That's how I got what I have today. This would have never been possible otherwise. So by the end of this year, this thing will all be put together and we can make it a fully functional derby shop. We'll have everything sorted and cleaned, and then we can figure out what kind of big goodies we want to put in here. Possibly a plasma cutter, portable plasma cutter would be nice. Definitely would like to get myself a tire machine. That would be great as well, considering we do a lot of tires for these front-wheel drive cars with our tire flaps and grooving. But just some thoughts for long-term. We'll see how it goes, and we'll come back to it. But this is our Derby Shop update with almost a finished product. Hopefully we'll have the last things done and I'll give you guys a good final video of the whole shop all said and done and everything put together. So, hope everybody is enjoying the end of the Demolition Derby season. The off season is upon us. Stay tuned, we will have the 2020 Derby teaser trailer coming out before this year is over, usually in December sometime. And I already have two new vehicles to the collection that you guys have not seen yet. One of them is going to be stored in here because we're going to build it next year pretty early in the spring. The other one is parked in my cinder block garage, buried in a back corner. Don't know if it'll be an extra car or not, but stay tuned on those two vehicles. You're going to be interested to see what both of them are. They're going to be fun builds. But all right, guys, this is Demolition Mission signing off for 2019. I'm going to see you guys back here. 2020 is going to be a big year. What are your guys' plans for 2020? Do anything specific? Comment below. I love to always hear what you guys got going on. And I'll see you later.